As you can see, this is a rope. And this rope, like all rope this side of the moon, has two ends and one middle. If I had two ropes, I would have four ends. If I had three ropes, I would have six ends. And now suppose just for a minute I had one rope and a half. How many ends do you think one would make? Yes, three. One, two, and three. I must say you are quite lucky today, because it is usually quite impossible to see a rope with three ends. And it is even more impossible, if quite possible, to see a rope with four ends, like this. Yes, but it seems we have a little problem here. These two ends are not on their proper place. If these two ends were here, what would be somewhat better? Look. Don't you think this looks a little less crazy? But we still have a rope with four ends. Two here and two over there. Actually, there are two ropes. This one and that one. Now, if I knot this rope into a loop and do the same thing with the other rope, we'll end up, of course, with two loops. One and two. Wouldn't it be great if we could make one single loop out of the two? Here you are. Well, this in fact is much easier to do when it looks. The only thing you must be able to do is to make a knot disappear. Let me show you. As you can see, this is a knot. And now, it's not a knot. Okay. Where were we before an explanation? Ah, yes. We had one single big loop, like this. And now for you, the famous trick of the traveling end. Look. This is a rope, and the first end. Second end. And of course, the middle of the rope. Now something else, much easier to understand. If I knot these two ends together, like this, it's impossible to put the two ends here. But, look. And now, the two ends travel from here to there. Now something else, without any ends. If I put here these two ends into my pocket, like this, I won't be able to make a knot here like this. And of course, with the two ends in my pocket, it's also quite impossible to undo the knot. And the funny thing is, when the knot vanishes, so do the ends. And what have we got now? An endless rope. Where are the ends? In my pocket. So, on the one hand, I have a rope without any ends, and on the other hand, two ends without a rope. If I put these two ends on the rope, it looks quite normal. And if I pull on it, it becomes normal indeed. Okay. As you're being such nice audience, let me show you the famous cut and restore rope trick. The same old robe and the same old feeling, but a brand new pair of scissors. If I cut the rope, we get, of course, two ropes, one and two. To restore it, it's very easy. If I pull here, this one gets longer, while the other one gets shorter. And if I stop right here, the rope is nearly restored, as we have a long rope here and a small one there. Let's conclude on a happy rope. On a happy note. If you want all rope back is what it was at the beginning, we only have to push the little one here into the big one, like this, very slowly. Nice and smooth. And now we are left with a knot. Undo it, and you are left with a rope.
Single guy in town. Hey, hey, hey. Thank you. I will ask different person to name any card. So just shout any card and cheers. So, anyone, please name any card.
Ten of spades.
Pardon?
Ten of spades.
Ten of spades, perfect. And you should say two of
hearts.
Hearts. Good. Ten of spades. So first I will try to locate ten of spades. I will do it very, very quick, but in slow motion so you can follow. Right? Ten of spades. And next card was two of hearts. Okay. In this case, I will spread the deck. And we use ten of spades. And you say stop anywhere.
Stop.
Here?
Yes.
Two of
hearts.
Hearts, yes. Two of hearts. This was actually an example of a card switch, which is very useful in cheating methods. Of course, I never cheat, but I like the methods. I don't like the cheater's moral, but I'm very interested in gambling techniques. And okay, we have two cards, two of spades and two of hearts. Another person, another card. Any? Pardon?
Ace
of diamonds. So not ace of hearts? No, diamonds. Okay. Which card shall I change to ace of diamond? Maybe 10 or 2? Your decision?
10.
Ace of diamonds. So I switch it with 10. Yes. Now I can use 10 of diamonds to demonstrate different gambling slides. For example, second deal. Second deal, in this case, you have the card second from top, and you deal the card like this. Middle deal, here, you have the card in the middle. And for example, if I have a die here, name the number of the die.
Six.
Dice, six. So the sixth card will be ace of diamonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I will do it a little quicker, more smooth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6. Oh. Thank you. Face up, and if I exaggerate, you'll see the card coming. Another way to find a card very quick from the center is this. You see, I square the pack and do this. I think I will use. Now a false count to any number, and which card shall I use?
Two.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. The same card all the time. Eight, nine, ten. Yeah. Thank you. The reason why this works is when I put one card at the table like this, it's not one card, it's actually a bunch of cards, but it looks like one, right? So here, if you look, and then I can use it as a... Now, a little dangerous thing. And I will use two hearts. Hopefully, yeah. Here. So, oh, sorry. Don't look at the beam. Because, my fault. It's enough, sorry to say, but it's enough with a fraction of a second to destroy the retina. Yeah, I should have mentioned that in advance. Because this is the strongest laser ever invented. But you can relax. It takes half an hour before it works, so you have plenty of time to see my whole performance, right? I think I take off my jacket. So, you see the beam? Now, I deal the cards in the beam. And immediately, when they reach the beam, they disappear, right? Yeah. Okay. Then, I take two of hearts and move it back. Take back the other one. Put back two of hearts. Yeah. Now, anyone, please name any suit. Another person?
Queen of Hearts.
Not Queen, a complete suit. Now we can take Queen of Hearts, you also decide. Wait, wait. Mm-hmm. For you. Sorry, Queen of Hearts. Then we take a complete suit, right? The first Queen of Hearts. Yeah. Right? And then a suit, clubs. So now my strategy is to locate clubs. So in this case, I think now I have, yeah. Perfect. So, yeah, clubs. Okay. So here is the clubs. Maybe some people think I already have the cards in order. So I will repeat this after a really genuine shuffle. Can anyone, if... Yeah, you can help me. Put them back. Good. And maybe you can help me to shuffle.
Yeah.
Betty, right?
Debbie.
Debbie.
Yeah.
Betty. So everybody, let's see the shuffle. Push the cards slow together so they are really interlaced. Right. Maybe two cards together on top. So we do it once again. Yeah, fine. Face up or face down? Is this okay?
Okay.
Now, you push them slow. Great. Thank you. So now we have created the order of chaos, right? This is always a challenge, right? I mean, what to do? Every shuffle is unique. Not the shuffle maybe, but the order of the cards. So the first challenge here is how to arrange the cards in red, black, for example. Here there are big groups of red. They are not alternating anyway. If I will do an alternating shuffle, I do this. Now I have them red, black, red, black. Now, this is not interesting. The interesting happens now, when they are not in order, and I start here at this, and I deal opposite. And if you look at the cards, the colors, immediately when they reach the table, they change to the correct color, right? I can do it, yeah. So in this heap, no hidden black cards, and in this heap, no hidden, one hidden red card. That was your card from the beginning. The next challenge is how to arrange these cards in. In once again, in the four suits. Well, this needs. No, I think I do it this way. Yeah. So here is the clubs. Yeah. Two mistakes. No, it's perfect. a quick checkup on it. Diamonds, thank you, and clubs, and actually I didn't mention this, but I am a perfectionist, so I also arranged the cards in, numerical order, yeah, we check here, one, yes, exactly, so if I count them like this, one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Jack, Queen, King. Diamonds. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Clubs. See? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, Queen, King. And her. Thank you. And this is almost true. Once in Gothenburg, at a gambling club, I did this as a friendly demonstration. But The owner of the blackjack table was apparently a little bit irritated, so he took my deck and shuffled it, in my opinion, a little aggressive. And he also banned ace of clubs. Yeah. And then he asked me to arrange them in order. Sorry, I can get... This was, of course, a piece of cake. I said, of course, I will do it. But the hard way. It's too easy to do it right away. Can you see any order?
No.
No, neither could he, right? Yeah. So I said, okay, I will do it the hard way. Blindfolded. First of all, I have very strong glasses, right? So, first I threw them away. But still I can see. At this distance, it works immediately. And then, but still, maybe some people can think as... Melinda, can you help me? Yes, right on. All over. And some magician tried to peek down here, so be careful.
Right.
I don't like it. Cheating people, no? More brutal, right? You are too nice, too kind, yeah.
Okay.
More
tough.
Tough, more tough. Good. Yes.
More?
More, yeah. And this one. And check it out.
What about your eyebrows? Won't they?
Yeah, I think a good effect is worth some those eyebrows, brows, right? These two, yeah. And now, yeah. Good. And this, now these two. Yeah. Good. Thank you. Very good. Oh, all right. I'm now. At this moment, I always ask this question. What time is it? I mean, it's to put yourself in this position, it's not always pleasant, but it's a challenge, right? Mm-hmm. Now, it's here I must use other senses than yeah, perfect. Ace? Oh, spades? Ah, sorry. Yes? Three. Two. Oh, sorry. Here. Yeah. You can shake. Two. Right? Yes. Three. Three. This. Thank you. So far, I have never, ever missed four. I always get four. This is interesting. But wrong color. But here. Five. I think I hurry up a little. Maybe you think this is too sloppy. I will do it more elegant. And now number five.
You have five.
I have five. Number six.
Six.
Right? So, I think I will shuffle the cards. Are all the cards face down?
Yes.
Sure. And now I'm looking for which card?
Seven.
Yeah. Is seven face up?
Yes.
Go. Yeah. Eight with a thumb. Nine of spades. Correct?
Yes. Ah.
Ten. Ten of spades. Yes. Jack. Jack is difficult. Jack of...
No.
Yes!
Oh,
yeah! Here, Queen. Queen with a little misdirection. Misdirection. Six, right? What is this? What color is this?
Red.
Which card?
Three of hearts.
Three. And this? This is?
Two of hearts.
Yeah, good. So now the king, after exact 3 seconds, say stop.
Stop.
Correct? Three seconds. One, two, and three. Yes.
Some interesting things. This is a Finnish Finnmark coin. We all know why money is important for all of us. But why this chime is important, I tell it to you at the end of my show. Otherwise, the purse is completely empty. But this, come on, hop. Come on, this is my assistant. Please take a seat. Oh, it's really pretty. Yeah, yes, you can take a look inside. Yeah. Okay, one more. Yeah, please take a seat. Oh, it's beautiful. Do you have to do this? There is an egg, a cold one, all the way from Finland. I have to warm up my hands. It's really cold. I try. Oh, hey, 2 ice cubes. Wow, look at this. One more. I try. Hop. Yeah, one more. Yes, 4 ice cubes between my hands, and they are really cold. Yes, it's really cold all the way from Finland, so I have to dry off my hands. So, oh, where's the ice cubes? Oh, maybe you don't trust me. Okay, watch this. One more. Come on here. Come on out. Okay, one more. Did you see that? Yes, this is an ice cube. Yeah. Of course, this is a small one. I can make it bigger. And, oh, it's wet. Okay, back to the saw. And we go, oh, this is not the right place for the ice cube. It's going to melt. Oh, I borrow this one. Yeah. Oh, what is this? It looks very familiar for me because this is my magic wand. And back to the saw. Oh, okay, I dry off my hands because this magic wand is really useful. I can, for example, pick up things from the table like this, or I can slide things into my hand like this, or I can use this like a magic wand. Watch. Oh, it's a bell. And listen the sound, it's perfect. Oh, I'm sorry, there must be something inside. Oof, it's a coin. A big one. Big. Maybe there is more coins inside. Let's have a look. Oh, it's only a chime. But this is a big coin. Ooh, really big one. Ah. Money is in circulation. If you play cards and gamble, it's really, really, really important you know where the high cards are. So I try to find a high card. I hope. Ace of Hearts. It's a high card. Yeah. Okay, what's this? Ace of Spades. It's a high card too. One more. Ace of Clubs. And what's this? Come on. Up. Ace of Diamonds. But if you play cards and gamble, you can easily lose your money. So wouldn't it be wiser to take out money from the cards like this? Ooh. Or maybe like this. Ooh, it's a big one. Hey, where did you come from? Between my cards. This it's really heavy one. Especially this one. It's like a bomb. At the beginning of my show, I had a black little purse. Where did I put it? I should put this coin inside the purse if I only find it. Okay, never mind. What's the coin? Oh, this is the purse. There is something inside. Oh, it's a chime. One more. Yeah. In Finland, we got lots of reindeers. You know, reindeers running in great fogs. And those chimes belongs to the reindeers. And I got hard work to get those chimes from the reindeers. But guess what I had to do to get these? Oof. I had to run really hard because those belongs to the horses. Oof. And to start, I'm going to put those chimes under the bells. One, two, three chimes. And here we go. I take chime number one and put it into my pocket. Take out the second chime and put it into my pocket. And start with only one chime. And here we go. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Yes, I will be in that number when the saints go marching in. And this is empty. And here I got two chimes. But if I take this chime and put it into my pocket, only touch with my magic wand, the chime is back. If I put the chime one more time under the bell and even take the last chime from my pocket, the second one under this bell and the last go right into my pocket, only touch with my magic wand. And the chime is back. It's a bell. And this is a bell too. And this is a bell. Oh, that's nothing. It used to be a bell, but this is a coin. Ooh, a coin. Maybe here's a coin too. Yes! Maybe here's a coin too. Come on out. Okay, I'll help you. Yeah! And this is a little chime. And this is a bell. Well, and this is a little chime. And this make a big sound because this is a big coin. Ooh. Big money. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Yes. And this is a big one. Ooh. It's a big bell, but look at inside. This is a big coin. Thank you.